What's up guys, welcome back to another Battlerite champion guide. This is Andre of Gaming Hardcore, and we're gonna be talking about Varesh, the Eternal. Okay, we're gonna be explaining the abilities first, then the Battlerites or loadouts, then the strengths and weaknesses, and of course some of my opinion of the Eternal. What are we waiting for? Let's do this! The first ability that we're gonna be talking about is Hand of Corruption. Hand of Corruption is an attack that deals 14 damage and heals you for 2 HP and inflicts corruption on enemies. So what is corruption? Corruption is a debuff that reduces the damage and healing of enemies by 15% for 5 seconds. The good thing about this debuff, aside from the reduced damage and healing, is you can consume corruption with the ability called Shatter. And Shatter is an ability that deals 12 damage in a small area and consumes Corruption or Judgement debuff. So if you consume Corruption by shattering an enemy with Corruption debuff, you get healed by 8 HP and inflict Fading Snare on the targeted enemy for 1 second. So basically, you don't just attack an enemy and deal 12 damage, you also get healed and snare the enemy. Before we talk about the Judgement debuff, first, I'm gonna explain the ability that causes it, and it's Hand of Judgement. Now, Hand of Judgement is an ability that deals 22 damage with a slightly longer reach than the basic attack and also inflicts Judgement debuff. So what is Judgement debuff? Well, Judgement increases the damage taken by enemies by 15%, so you gotta think about it if you wanna consume this, or just leave the debuff on them or reapply it, because this increased damage taken is a lot. So if you decide to consume it, your Shatter will deal 8 bonus damage and silence the enemy for half a second. Now let's head on to the next ability we're gonna be talking about, which is Wuju. Now Wuju is your counter. When triggered, you can teleport to whatever location near you that you choose. And when you choose to teleport to an enemy with Corruption or Judgement debuff, you can consume those. So when you teleport to an enemy with Corruption, you get healed and you inflict Fading Snare. And if the enemy has Judgement, you deal 8 damage and silence them. This ability is very important because it's good both offensively or defensively. But much more important to use offensively. Because there are Battlerites that improve this ability to a point that doesn't just avoid an attack. It can also be used to consume and inflict Judgement debuff. And can also be recasted. Look at this. Just wanna add that you can counter some attacks like Serious Ultimate. So if you try to counter that, you're just gonna get destroyed. So better remember that and dash away or shield up whatever you want. The next ability we're gonna be talking about is Kinetic Energy. Now this turns you immaterial and dashes towards your targeted location and summons a Shatter when you pass through enemies. This is one thing to remember. This is not just your iframe. You can also use this to consume Corruption or Judgement, which I find very useful when I don't have any other means to consume a debuff. So keep that in mind. The next ability we're gonna be talking about is Inhibitor's Guard. This grants you 28 shield that can be used on allies. Now I only find this ability useful when I don't have counter or kinetic energy. And also, yeah, this is also useful when you have a team that wanna Rambo YOLO enemies 1v3 and he keeps chasing enemies so far from the mid and you can't just leave him there. You can use this to back him up a little. It happens. The next ability is Hand of Punishment. This deals 16 damage and heals you for 6 HP and inflicts both Corruption and Judgement, but requires energy. This is good if you want to inflict both debuffs ASAP. The next ability is Crush. This is another version of Shatter that deals 12 area damage with a slightly larger area of attack and knocks enemies back. This is a good skill for pushing melee champions that are really on you. This is also good to use on sudden death for pushing enemies outside the ring. The last ability that we're gonna talk about is your ultimate ability, Powers Combined. I know, it sounds like a move from a Power Ranger TV show. But anyway, this deals 24 damage and inflicts both debuffs and repeats the attack 3 times. Assuming you hit, because if you miss, the ability ends. Now that we're done with abilities, let's talk about the Battlerites or your loadouts. The first Battlerite we're gonna be talking about is Fervor. Now this Battlerite gives you 8% move speed each time you consume Corruption and can stack up to 3 times. Now this Battlerite is optional. I mostly don't use this because I don't find Varesh to be that slow. But at times that I experiment and change things up, I find it good in combination with the next Battlerite I'm gonna be talking about, which is Unlimited Power. Now, Unlimited Power increases the duration of Fading Snare of Corruption and reapplies Corruption every time you consume it, meaning you can continually consume Corruption until you run out of Shatters. And if you have the Battlerite Fervor, you can easily get 3 stacks of movement speed buff. The third Battlerite we're gonna be talking about is Devastation. This gives Hand of Judgment 3 damage and resets its cooldown every time it hits. Now listen, the cooldown of Hand of Judgment is just 2 seconds, and if you find it good to reset it ASAP, even though it only has 2 seconds of cooldown, knock yourself out and enjoy using this. And please remember, you can't miss, because the cooldown will not reset. Anyway, it's just 2 seconds. The fourth Battlerite is Silence. Now this increases the silence duration when you consume Judgment debuff from 0.5 seconds to 1 second. This Battlerite is good if you inflict and consume Judgment all the time, which I do, and that increased duration helps a lot. The fifth Battlerite is Celerity. This gives Inhibitor's Guard extra 25% move speed and increased damage output by 15%. This Battlerite is decent if you have a teammate that has a really good burst damage. The next Battlerite is Wonder. Now this gives extra 14 shield to your Inhibitor's Guard. This is pretty self-explanatory. Use this if you think your shield is not enough. The seventh Battlerite is Zeal. This gives Inhibitor's Guard the ability to consume Corruption and heal an ally for 8 HP for each Corruption consumed. Now, this Battlerite is good if you don't have another means to consume Corruption, or if you just wanna defend and consume Corruption at the same time. One thing to remember though, this doesn't work with Unlimited Power. I don't know if it's a bug or it's intended, because it doesn't reapply Corruption when you use Zeal to consume Corruption when you have Unlimited Power. Anyways, I will put it in the description if they change it, but for now, it doesn't reapply. The 8th Battlerite is Return. This gives you the ability to recast Wuju after it's triggered, but only for 1.5 seconds. This is a must, because this is also a means to consume, especially if you have the next Battlerite we're gonna be talking about, which is Ruin. Now, Ruin gives Wuju the ability to inflict Judgment debuff on enemies when you teleport near them. And when you have the Return Battlerite, you can consume the first Judgment debuff you inflicted and reapply Judgment again. And that's a really good combination. And what's Varesh is all about. Continuous debuff and consuming while reapplying it again. The 10th Battlerite is Fracture. This basically gives you another charge for Shatter. Now, this Battlerite is good in combination with Unlimited Power, because if you have this, you can spam 3 Shatters on enemies inflicted by Corruption, since it reapplies every time consumed. The 11th Battlerite is Inhibitor. This gives Shatter the ability to cast while moving, but at 75% move speed. Number 12 on the Battlerite list is Law Bender. This reduces the cooldown of Inhibitor's Guard by 1.5 seconds every time you consume a debuff. If your playstyle includes powered up Inhibitor's Guard, go ahead, use this. It actually helps in some situations. The next Battlerite is Kinetic Judgement. This basically adds Judgement debuff to your Kinetic Energy, meaning when you pass through an enemy, you will inflict Judgement and then consume it with the summoned Shatter. The 14th Battlerite is Absolute Power. This adds an additional 1 extra attack to your ultimate ability, assuming you hit every time. This is decent if you are confident in your aiming. The 15th Battlerite is Inspiration. This increases your max energy by 25% and increases energy gain by 10%. The last Battlerite is Synergy. Now this gives you the ability to reapply Corruption and Judgement with either Hand of Judgement or Hand of Corruption, assuming they have both the buff active on them. Now that we're done with the Battlerites, let's talk about the strengths and weaknesses. Let's start with the strengths. Varesh's strength lies in his ability to debuff enemies and his continuous silence. You do this by taking advantage of your counters and using it as an offensive ability to consume whatever debuff they have, and inflicting judgment and recasting Wuju and consuming judgment and reapplying it again. By doing this, you can continually debuff and silence enemies, and what you do after that is your choice. Now for the weakness. To be honest, I don't really see any weakness in Varesh. The only thing I can say is this is not a beginner-friendly champion. And probably the delay on his basic attack, yeah that, which is kinda long, but I guess they intentionally did it because you inflict a debuff when you hit. Now what do I think about Varesh? Varesh is a perfect example of a well-balanced champion, and a champion that definitely needs skill to play to fully utilize him. Most people say that Varesh lacks mobility. Now listen, if they give Varesh another means to dash or whatever you want, it will make him much more harder to pin down than he already is. Because right now, Varesh is at that perfect spot where you have sufficient answers to pretty much everything you throw at him. So what you need to do, if you find Varesh lacking, is you need to play even more and get good. That's it guys, that's my Varesh guide, hope you guys like it. Please comment down below if you have questions and share. And this is Unreal Gaming Hardcore, see you in the next one.
Your team won the orb. Match victory.
All stand as one.